everyone. So I thought it would be fun to give you a little behind the scenes of how this practical tarot deck is coming together, because this isn't a deck where I'm going out and you know, finding clip art pictures to be the cards. These cards are actually designed between me and Holly Carton, who is phenomenal illustrator, and basically each and every card we have been designing to have multiple symbolisms in each card. So I thought I would go through that and give you guys kind of the background on how much, you know, effort and love is going into every card on this deck. So first up, what happens is Holly is not a tarot card reader and she's not familiar. So every card that we set out to do, I give her all the meanings of the card. I give her any symbolism that I really want in it. And she is very into flowers, which is not my strong suit. But I told her, please, if you have a flower that really, you know, goes into that theme, I know lots of people are, so let's have them represented. I want this deck to be something that people can turn over the card and connect with it, even if they're not sure what the traditional meaning is of that card. So together, we have been working on this, and it's really been magical. So basically, what happens first is I give her the write-up of the card, what the traditional meaning is of the card, the things that I want to see on the card, and any, you know, design ideas. I pretty much leave it up to her at the beginning. And then what she'll send me, I don't know if you can even really see the pencil sketches, but this top one was for the Fool, and we had someone stepping off the cliff. We had someone, she is hopping off the cliff there. And this one, she's balancing on the cliff and blindfolded. And so Holly gives me these usually three ideas, and I pick which pose I like best. And so for the Fool, I really liked her not leaping off of the edge, because the Fool is all about taking a leap of faith, but it takes trust, right? So it's hard. And so I picked the one of her just about to walk off. And we talked about, you know, that when you draw the Fool, it means take that risk because you won't look foolish, right? So take that risk, go on that new journey. It's a new quest for you kind of thing. And she thought, what if I put butterflies around her, you know, for transformation? And then we played with it some more, and it was, what about if she doesn't know that she's building wings? And anyone who knows me from the writer world knows that Ray Bradbury, I got to meet him a couple of times, and it really changed my life. He was so phenomenal and so in love with words. But one of his favorite quotes is, you know, to jump off the cliff and build wings on the way down. And so when she said, maybe she has wings and she doesn't know it, I was just like, oh, I was teary-eyed. Yes, yes, that's what we want. So here is the Fool, and these I just printed out on my printer, so of course it sucked out all the vibrancy of the color. The real deck is going to be vibrant and beautiful, but these are just out of my home printer. But you can see she is just stepping off there, and there are the wings that she is going to build on her way down. We also decided on a sunrise for a whole new day, right? And she included daffodils in here, which daffodils signify a new beginning. So it just all came, it also signifies rebirth. And so that was the Fool card. And then for the Two of Cups, I also told Holly that my goal with this deck is that I want everyone to find themselves in it. A lot of times tarot will be themed, like my little jack-o'-lantern tarot here, you know, themed for Halloween. I have a Disney villain tarot. But a lot of the tarot decks aren't necessarily very diverse. And I love the Light Seers tarot deck because it really is, so highly recommend. But what I told Holly is I really want everyone to be able to find themselves in these cards. So we are doing our best to make sure that everyone is representative. We have every size, we're gonna have every age, you know, so that you can, everyone should be able to see themselves on this journey through a tarot deck. So when we came up with the two of cups, she gave me these different designs here. I don't know, again, if you can see them very well, but one had the couple behind each other with a cup. Another one was a couple who are actually in water with the cup. And one was very up close with the two cups and the people. And that was the one that I chose because the two of cups, remember, cups is the element of water. It represents our emotions. And the two is really that healthy union, healthy partnership of coming together of hearts. You know, it's like the true love card. And so I talked to her about it. We went back and forth and I was like, if you could put an infinity sign, you know, for never ending love, that would be great. And she asked about which flower. Jasmine flowers represent eternal unconditional love. And she said, could I include jasmine flowers? I said, yes, please. And look what she did with them. So all the tattoos are jasmine flowers. Isn't that great? And she put in my infinity sign is actually what's hand fasting the cups together. And it's a green background, which represents your heart chakra. What? So anyway, I'm so happy with how the card turned out. And of course, the two cups are there. All right. And again, I'm so sorry about the color. This is just out of my printer, the real one, super colorful, like what you see out and that I'm posting everywhere. Okay. Then we worked on the death card and I wanted her to do the death card because it's one of the cards in a tarot deck that TV makes look really scary. But the truth is it's not a mortal death. No piano's gonna fall on you. The death card is about closing a chapter so that you can open a new one. So it's about a new rebirth. It's about letting, the reason they call it death is, you know, flowers die so that new flowers can be reborn. And in our life, since everything runs in a cycle, the death card just simply means time to wrap up this chapter so you can open a new one. And for this card, I had sent her some examples of cards that I liked. But then what happened was a TikTok filter. So basically there was a TikTok filter of the video, the Take On Me video from the 80s where they stepped into a black and white cartoon. And so I was playing with it on TikTok and, you know, I was half in, half out. So I was half in color and half in black and white. And I went, I wonder if that would work. So I emailed Holly and I said, you know, could the death part be black and white for, you know, that this part is done and over and then we walk into color? And she said, I think I can make that happen. I'm like, woohoo! So I'm so in love with our death card. So here is the traditional, here's death. Here she is. It's all black and white. And you'll notice Holly added here the, what kind of trees are these? Cypress trees. And cypress trees represent death and mourning. So that's the black and white tree behind them. But as she rises up, here's the daffodils for the new beginning, the oak trees for strength, and she's walking directly into the sun of a new day, right? So I just love this death card. It is all about the rebirth, right? And now life is colorful again. Oh, love it. Okay. And then next up we worked on the sun because the sun is one of my favorite cards in the tarot deck, not only because I'm a Leo, so I am a fire sign, but I think that the sun card is like the one good luck card in the tarot deck. You flip over the sun card and you're like, the world loves me right now. And so she sent me, I don't have the sketches in front of me, but she sent me some sketches for the sun. And one had her with her arms up with the sun huge behind her. And I said, that's the one. That's the one I want. And I told her I want sunflowers on the card. That's pretty traditional for a sun card because they're happiness and joy. And I told her it needs to have lots of yellow and orange. Orange is the passion of fire to do things, and yellow is, of course, joy and happiness. And this is what she came up with. I love that she is full figured there in front of the sun in all her power, and the sunflowers for happiness and joy. And she added, what is the other flower on here? Oh, I forgot to write down the other flower on here. It's a wisteria, I think, which is all about abundance. So anyway, love, love it. Okay, and then our newest card that we just unveiled for the Kickstarter was the Ace of Pentacles. And I wanted her to, we haven't designed all of the cards yet because Holly is an artist. My mom was a watercolorist, and I just believe artists need to be paid. It takes so much work and effort and practice, and she's so amazing. So unless this funds, I didn't want her to put out all of this effort and not get paid for it. So we decided, okay, we'll make 5 cards for the Kickstarter, and in hopes that it will fund. So I wanted, you know, we did the Death card and the Fool and the Sun, and then the 2 of Cups was the True Love card, but I wanted one ace because the aces in the Minor Arcana are all a new cycle. They're all full of hope. They're full of possibility, all that kind of thing. So I really wanted to capture that. So I asked her if we would do the Ace of Pentacles, and I'm so happy with how it turned out, because Pentacles is the element of earth. It's your earthly goods, your earthly body. And a lot of times, I feel like on a lot of tarot decks, we lose the grounding part of a pentacle, of earth, of, you know, that kind of thing. So when I was talking to her about this, I said, maybe we could make the pentacle be the seed that the flowers are growing out of. And she loved it. She was like, oh my gosh, I got this. And this is what we came up with. So you can see it is actually this daffodil, the new beginning, is growing right out of that pentacle. And on our first draft, there was no color in the pentacle. I told her, could we get yellow and orange in there for passion and fire and, you know, this new cycle? And so she did. And when it's not out of my printer, it almost glows. It's so beautiful with all of this hope and promise for a great new cycle. And I love that it is a nice day up there and that you are watering that flower. Your effort is making it bloom. Love it. So that is kind of the background on how we are designing the tarot cards. And then I just wanted to read you just really quick the foreword from the book that I'm writing to go with it. And the book is not, there will be a little guidebook with every deck that tells you the meanings of the cards, so you don't have to worry about that. But the book itself is about learning to read tarot intuitively so that you don't need that little guidebook that is going to come with the cards. You can trust your own intuition. And yes, so all of that information will be in the book, but the book is also going to take it a step further to give you different tips and techniques for reading from your gut, reading using your intuition and growing your intuition and your confidence in your intuition through tarot cards. It also has at the ending chapters about how you can actually use tarot cards in your everyday life, because the more we use them, the better we get with this tool. And so I want to give people opportunities to look at tarot in a different way, like it is a tool, like it's something I can use every single day. So that will also be in the book. But here's the foreword, and I thought it would be fun to share it with you guys because this is the background on the project. There are no coincidences. We've all heard that phrase, but over the years, I've come to accept the truth in it. The universe is made of energy, and we are all part of it, woven into a galaxy of stars. This book crossed your path for a reason. Divine timing is at work, and you are right where you're supposed to be. There's comfort in that inner knowing when we feel most connected to our higher self. This book is meant to deepen your confidence and develop more trust in your own intuition. Tarot cards are a powerful tool to help us tap into spirit and guide us. My hope is that this book will make learning to read tarot fun and easy. I've been teaching my practical tarot method for years, as well as teaching writers and artists to use tarot to help them tap into their creator's intuition. It was while I was teaching a group of writers recently that I realized it was finally time to write this book. Tarot cards have been a big part of my life for over 20 years, and I've been a professional fiction writer for the past 10 years now. But this was the first time that I'd ever considered bridging the two worlds and pulling them together. And to be honest, it terrified me to contemplate writing a nonfiction book. You might have a similar feeling of apprehension just thinking about studying tarot. Change and growth are often uncomfortable. Growing pains, right? Anyway, I turned to my cards for some insight and inspiration, and I pulled the Empress and the Page of Wands. They will be my inspiration for this new journey with you. The Empress calls us to manifest our dreams. The time for growth is now. And the Page of Wands asks us to bring a youthful joy and childlike energy to the action of learning. I hope you'll dive into this study with that same kind of enthusiasm too. There are no coincidences. This book crossed your path for a reason. Maybe you've always had an interest in tarot. Maybe tarot cards keep showing up in your social media feed, or maybe you're just curious. Either way, I'm eager for you to join me on this journey, and I'm honored to walk this path with you. So that's the foreword of the book. And I'm hoping that this will all come to fruition on Halloween night. That's basically the, you know, background behind the beautiful, beautiful practical tarot cards deck. And then the book will teach you not only, you know, about reading tarot cards, but also how you can use them and make them part of everyday life so that you do get a greater connection with your higher self, with spirit, with your intuition. You'll start trusting your gut. I'm very passionate about it, obviously, and I hope that it will go. We are 60% of the way there, and with your help, we will hit that goal and the project will happen. And if everything goes smoothly and it does fund, then Holly and I will finish all those cards and the printer will take it from there and the book will go to the editor. And in March of 2023, everything should launch. I'm very excited. I hope that you guys are excited and that you'll back the project. And I really appreciate all your support. All of that information will be in the book, along with those extra things that I was talking about. Of course, there's going to be a couple chapters at the end about oracle cards because I do love those as well. But basically about using cards to tap into your intuition and using them for things that maybe people don't traditionally think of them for. Like I use them for writing all the time. But I know that a lot of times people feel like they only can read tarot cards when they're at a crossroads in their life or when it's the full moon or, you know, something like that. And really, you can pull those cards off and use them every day for all kinds of things. So that will all be in the book as well. Thank you guys for being here. I hope it was interesting seeing, you know, the artist sketches and how they all came to be. Thank you guys so much and keep sending out good vibes for Practical Tarot. I think it's going to be a fantastic project and I can't wait to share it with the world. So thank you so much for all your support and for helping make it happen. And I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.